I'm going to go through this algebra, so if you are an ace at solving these sorts of systems of equations, you can skip this part. But for those who aren't, I'm going to walk you through it. So here we have our two equations. I like to write them one above the other to make things a little simpler for me. Now my goal is to eventually know what the acceleration of this system is. I'm going to do that by first solving for the tension in one of these equations, and then plugging in. And let me show you what I mean by that. So let's take this equation. If I move this term to this side, I find that the tension is equal to m1a, and a is still unknown, plus m1g. Why don't I plug this in, this value of the tension, into here? The idea being that now I'll get this equation in terms of only one unknown, a, and ft won't show up anymore. So I rewrite m2g minus ft, but now using this, and that equals m2a. Let's just distribute this minus sign and lose the parentheses. Well, now I'm solving for a. So let's group all the a terms together. I'm going to move this a over here. Okay, so now that we've done that, I'm going to take out the common factors of each of these terms and each of these terms. So for example, each of these terms has a g in it, and each of these terms has an a in it. And now we're really close. Let's divide both sides by this term here. And here is our answer, and this is truly a thing of beauty. And let me explain why.